reiterating the points I need to take care of, and thank you, Santosh, for giving such a nice introduction. Okay. I am right now freezing at 0 degrees Celsius, and probably by the end of this my speech, I'll be probably melted by the warmth of these Toastmasters. Hello everyone. You must be now understanding that, okay, I am here for the icebreaker, which is my project one, finally. Okay, this has been in the cards for quite some time now, and I have been put into the sheet and then removed for whatsoever reasons, and then finally now I am here delivering project one. Okay, it has been quite a race between me and my wife with respect to project one, and I was comfortable for most of the time, but finally my wife won it a couple of months back, hands down, because I'm actually referring to my baby, which is our combined project one. So finally, she actually stayed ahead of me. And then I would first give some disclaimers about my project one so that you can know what to expect. One is the language. Probably I might be inclined to use some local language like Hindi. Probably this was more a disclaimer for Taufik, who was here. Mm-hmm. But now it's okay. It's all an Indian affair now. So this disclaimer can be probably discounted. And then the speech could be a little unstructured. I am actually leveraging on the luxury of being project one. So it could be a little unstructured with a lot of pauses and stuff like that. And then I'm, as you already observed, I'm making it an open book exam type. So where I have already a piece of paper, which would probably serve as an index to query the database called my memories. Okay, and then most importantly, I would, my special request to the timer and the counter to be fair to me and considerate to me, so that I can share, give my share of samosa and cold drink to you later. Okay, now, okay, project one, actually it's an all about me affair. That's what makes feel nice, that okay, it's all about me. It's more of an impromptu. It can be an impromptu, though it is a prepared speech. You can be impromptu about the content that you're going to talk about. So that is, whoever has invented this or discovered this approach, it is a very nice thing in my opinion. So right away plunging into my autobiography, I'll start with my name, which would probably make more sense. I'll take some time to write it down, and it might take a few seconds. Some of my might already be knowing my name in a different order, actually. Some funny, actually my name is not as famous as JRD's name, where I can share it with some people, personalities like JRD, Tata or anyone. It's a very simple name, but nevertheless a lengthy one. Okay, some highlights of my name are like, it is a 32 character long name with two spaces in it. And the funny thing is, there is only one of it, and it is A, and it spans across 5 times in my name. And then my name uses 14 characters of the English alphabet. So that's quite a bit of, considering that we have a 26 character alphabet, that's a bit of usage, thanks to my grandfather, who has actually coined me this name. And then, like I said, it's a long name actually. So I always end up, even while writing, I was at this stage probably, I was thinking whether the board will be enough or not. So I see the same situation in all the application forms, immigration forms and stuff like that. So it's a long name, and a lot of O's that I had in several countries like China, USA. In China, they broke it into 3-piece names like the Kan, Chu, Gan. So they made it like a Chinese set of Chinese names probably, which 10 people could associate with. And then I don't know how the other people having bigger names will actually manage. So the takeaway from this background is that I'm going to put my son a short name, which is very easy to write and read and pronounce. So that was the takeaway from this. Okay, now going, actually starting with my childhood, I was born in a small town in Andhra Pradesh, It was undivided Andhra Pradesh, and now also it's part of Andhra Pradesh only, fortunately. So that I don't need to change it. And then I can relate my infancy. One of my infancy incidents where my mother used to narrate, where she was talking about when I was actually born, God has kind of pressed the mute button because I was not crying properly or I was not loud enough. So they were really worried, and then they took me to a doctor, and all he did was give a slap on my backside, and then I started crying to the extent of. So that is a funny thing which I can associate with my infancy. And then yesterday I was just in front of my mirror, and I was wondering how, trying to recollect memories, and then I saw the scars on my face, and then the memories came out slowly, right from the toe to head to toe. I have so many scars all across, which are actually checkpoints for my childhood, so that I can recollect all those incidents. But I think I am running out of time to talk about all of them. So I'll quickly move on to the next stage of my life, that is schooling. So I was associated, I had studied in the same school for 10 years. And at that stage itself, I had to take an entrance test as well as an interview to get into the first standard of my school. And fortunately, I made it with coaching from my father, and then luckily continued in the same school for 10 years. Then I entered the so-called teenage, which was probably the peak of my academic career, wherein I actually scored quite a few, got good ranks in the entrance examination and stuff like that, and my photo was flashed in the local newspaper for almost 30 days, where I was like, that was a sponsored page, not a missing or wanted one. So my college had sponsored that, but nevertheless I was over the moon at that point of time. And then moving on to graduation, I had to leave hometown. I was very associated with, very attached to my mother, and then that was really a challenge initially for me. Then later on, I hardly thought about home after getting into a hostel kind of mode. So then starting from using the scholarship and sending back money to home, I ended up in the final year to get the money back from home over and above the scholarship. So it was a progressive growth in my education, but an exponential growth in my expenses. So then I completed graduation, had no job for a month or so. Then I got a good job offer in Infosys, luckily. And then there was a little bit of a suspense there also for 6 months, where I didn't get the offer letter after they confirmed that I cleared the test and stuff. So that was a suspense period. Finally, I got in, and after that, most of the this is 10 years, 11 years in Infosys, I'm mostly with Finacle. And got to know a lot of great people and friends for lifetime, actually. And then making it short, because I already exceeded a lot of time, to summarize, actually, my like you say, right, that 80% of defects come from the 20% of the code. So it's like my 80% of memories are now actually in the 20% of the Infosys career I have spent. I hardly remember, I had to put an effort to remember all my childhood stuff, because what I mostly remember is the Infosys memories. Then after joining Finacle, it was more like a Bharat Yatra, where I had traveled to Mumbai, Delhi and places like that in my initial assignments, and then finally got an overseas travel to Singapore. I mean, incidentally, Singapore happens to be my first overseas travel. And then after, like you say, it all circles back. Now I'm here giving my project one after 11 years of Infosys career in Singapore. And then I traveled to China a few times. That was very nice experience with the kind of culture they have, where I had to manage with printouts more than the language. And then the US trip, which I went like PM Narendra Modi goes for a short trip on a nuke deal. I just went for 1.5 months. Make sure the project is closed and scrapped, and then came back, and probably I would want to add it as part of my resume. And then that's it about my journey. And in a brief about my family, my father is not there, but my mother is still in Hyderabad, and I have a a wife and a kid, a newly born kid, rather 2 months old. I am longing to see him for almost 1.5 months now. And then, and that's it from overall summary's perspective. I just want, one of my favorite quotes is what I wanted to put forth here is, I probably studied in one of my classes, I don't remember exactly which class, and it was the name of the poem was Leisure, and there were these two sentences which really I could never forget. I forgot all the academics I actually studied, but these things I could somehow not forget. It states actually, what is this life full of want and care, no time to stand and stare. Okay, so that is the quotation, which my favorite quote, which I would want to end with before you stare at me further. Thank you.